Yeah. T-Sharp. What it is, man. So it's like, they mad at the success. They mad at me. So, I gotta give them a reason why.
Everybody wanna hear a good show. Everybody wanna see a good show, good flow. Everybody wanna hear a good flow, good show.
Scared to be the best, but nothing like the rest. Young 50 Cent, yo, look how I'm doing
yo,
it.
Yo, 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 welcome to another episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. My name is Mr. Tariq Elite, also known as Tariq Nasheed. Bumping that new jam by T-Shock, bumping his new album called T-Shock the World, available at iTunes and available at Amazon.com. Real tight album called T-Shock the World. Let me play another cut from that. This cut is called One Phone Call. And I'd like to thank everybody for listening in today. I'm going to be taking a lot of calls today. I'm also going to read some letters from some of the listeners. I haven't done that in a minute.
Yeah.
And don't forget, like I said, go to Amazon.com and go to iTunes and get the new album by T-Shock, T-Shock the World.
Stay in your lane, man. Watch out. It's my lane. Let's go.
I ain't really gotta say much.
And don't forget, everybody, check out the brand new pay-per-view special, Sex Magic. You can get that at MackLessons.com. The Secret Sex Rituals of the Illuminati, Sex Magic, new pay-per-view special. Available at MackLessons.com. Very deep game in that pay-per-view special. I promise you, real deep-ass game. Let me take a couple of calls real quick. The phone lines are lighting up. Who's calling?
This is Jasmine again.
Hey, what's going on, Jasmine? How you doing, young lady?
I'm good.
So what's on your mind?
Okay, I'm in this situation where I'm talking to this guy. We consider each other best friends, right?
Okay.
And he has two different baby mamas.
Oh, okay.
Who cause a lot of trouble.
Those strike his one, dad, strike one, and strike two. Go ahead.
His dad recently died,
okay.
Right?
All right.
And we consider each other best friends. But I'm afraid to go to the house because his baby mamas are full of drama. So
wait. So is this, are you messing with this dude?
Yeah.
Okay, well, that's... Okay, I want to say, is he your man, or he's trying to be your man, or you want him to be your man? What's the deal?
I don't know, because one moment we're just friends, we're just best friends. That's what we consider each other. And then, but if I talk about other dudes or whatever, he gets mad.
Of course. Well, see, the thing is, you're a jump off. Now, let's not get it twisted. You are a jump off to him. And you're the homegirl. You're the homegirl that niggas just fuck every now and then. All of us have them. All the fellas have a homegirl who's real cool. You're real cool with her. And every now and then, when ain't nothing else popping, you'll tap that ass and going about your business. And this dude already has two baby mamas, so this dude ain't that responsible with his semen. And how old is this dude?
He's 25.
25 years old. Okay. And again, since you are just a jump off, you don't want to get involved with the baby mama drama. You don't want to get involved in all that because you guys don't really have no steady relationship. It's some old sometimey shit. So I would say to you to have him come holler at you or come kick it with him, go kick it with him when all those other people are not around, because you don't want to be in that mix. You don't want to be around these hood rats trying to fight you, and that ain't really your man anyway. You understand that?
Right.
So,
yeah.
But just call over, wish your condolences, send over some sweet potato pies or whatever, but don't go over there messing with them damn hood rats, because you don't want to get up in that damn mix. You understand? And find you a motherfucker who ain't got two damn baby mamas. How about that? That makes sense?
Okay.
All right, young
that
lady.
That makes sense.
All right, babe. Thanks for the call.
All right.
Ah, damn. You got a nigga with two baby mamas and all that old ghetto shit. What's up? Who's calling?
Hey, this is Ski from Denver.
What's up, Ski from Denver? How you doing, brother?
I'm chilling, man. I'm in school. I'm actually in Syracuse right now.
All right. What's going on in Syracuse?
The vibe is okay. I've kind of noticed quite a few simps in New York, though.
Oh, okay. Okay. So what's on your mind
today? The women, I just wanted to know, when is it time to, you know when to call it quits with your lady? Like, when y'all been trying and, you know, maybe breaking up and get back together, like, when is it time to just be like, look, you know, there's no future in this?
You should know this when you constantly are going through more trials than tribulations. When you start going through more bullshit than good times. You understand that? A lot of times, man, cats be dating women and it was cool about 2 years ago. And now you have grown mentally, emotionally apart, and you're just trying to put a circle into a square peg. And if everything is drama, fighting, bickering on a consistent level, that's when it's time to charge it to the game. Are you in a situation like that now?
Yeah, somewhat. You know, my chick, you know, we dated in high school just a year ago. And, you know, like, after she lost her virginity, she turned kind of into a new person. So that's been a struggle.
Now, did she lose her virginity to you?
Yeah.
Okay. See, that's another thing. A lot of times when women lose that virginity, it turns them into a little slut sometime. It's like a vampire. You know, once they get that taste of blood, they just go buck wild. And once they get a taste of dick, a lot of them don't know how to act. So a lot of them, again, your lady, she might have switched her game up and she wants to get out there and explore and go through her little attention whore stage. That's what it sounds
right.
like. That's what it sounds like. And sometimes you just got to let that shit go and let her do what she do, because you're too young to be in a long-term serious relationship yourself. How old are you?
19.
Yeah. And she's what, 19 too?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. So again, you guys are too young to try to be into some serious shit anyway. But thank you for the call, bro.
All right, man. Thanks. Peace.
All right, for sure. All right, let me take a couple of more calls. And don't forget, everybody, we got the brand new anti-moist shirts and hoodies available at antimoist.com. We got white, black shirts, the whole shebang. And we also have the brand new Hidden Colors hoodies, shirts, sweaters, everything at hiddencolorsfilm.com. Real good stuff. And don't forget to go there. Let me get a couple of more calls and I'm going to read a letter from one of my players. What's up? Who's calling?
Hey, what's going on, Tariq? This is Anthony from New York.
How you doing, Anthony from New York? What's on your mind, player?
Man, I'm all right. I just got to try to make this a quick question for you, bro.
Go ahead.
So basically, you know, I'm 26 now. I've had nobody on the team for like months right now.
But you're 20. Wait. First of all, you're 26. You sound young as hell, dude. You're 26?
I'm 26. God
damn, dude. You sound like a damn teeny bopper, man. Damn, how tall are you, dude? You a big dude or a small dude?
Nah, I'm 6'3".
You 6'3" with a voice like that, nigga? God damn, you sound young as hell. Let me play a song for you, god damn it. Oh, play some Justin Bieber for your ass. You sound mad young, dude. Let me play some Kitty Bop music for you. So anyway, I'm fucking with you, man. I'm messing with you. What's on your mind, though? What's on your mind?
So yeah, like I was saying, I got nobody on the team.
Okay.
But back in college, yo, I was like macking. Like, I was pulling crazy chicks. I don't know what happened with like the transfer when I went to the career, started focusing, getting my paper up, you know, I got my own place now. I'm doing the thing, but team is low. No roster.
Well, the thing is, the team is low now because right now you're in a different environment. When you were in college, you were in an environment where there were loose skanks at your disposal. You can just go outside your dorm or just go to one of the local parties and there was just a plethora of skanks. Now that you're an adult, you have a responsible lifestyle, though the disposable skanks aren't as abundant as they were. So it's really a numbers game. Now, right now, you really don't want to be around too many disposable skanks because you're a responsible dude. And to be around disposable skanks, you have to have some type of a very loose, carefree lifestyle. When you have a house, mortgage, career, you got to be careful about the people you bring around. You understand that? So that's just being, that's part of being an adult. So you just got to step your game up and step to a higher caliber of females. Now, there's nothing wrong with getting some loose skank booty every now and then. but you don't want to really trip on that. That should be like a once in a blue moon type of thing. You should go out to some new spots with some of your partners, hit up some new spots on the weekend, try some places you have not been to before, try some places outside of your immediate city, try some places on the other side of your city, but just try some new spots, change up your routine, and I guarantee you're going to get better results. And get my book, The Elite Way. I talk about that in The Elite Way. Have you read that?
No, I got it, but I haven't read that already.
Okay, yeah.
I read through the first one, The Art of Mackin.
Okay.
So, I definitely have it. It's sitting on the table, so I'll start picking that up tonight.
You better thumb through that tonight, player. All right, thank you for the call, brother.
All right, man.
All right, let me get a couple of more calls. That brother said he's 6'3 with that little-ass voice. God damn. Let's see who's calling right now. What's going on? Who's calling?
What's up, Flex?
What's going on? Who is this?
How you doing, Flex? My name is Paul from D.C.
Paul from D.C. How you doing, Pimp Sauce?
I'm doing good, Flex. I'm kind of shocked that you actually picked my phone call.
No, I'm here, man. Me and the Flex ready to chop up game with you. Did you come to my lecture in D.C. when I went?
No, my homeboy did. His name is King Nails.
Okay. You should have came through. You should have came through.
Over.
You should have came. We had a great time in D.C., man. You missed a good show. We had a great time out there.
Yeah, but I just got hip to who you were last September.
Oh, okay.
I didn't know. So I started listening to your podcast, reading your books, and I got hip to a lot of games. I got a third half of the game and everything like that.
That's real talk, but,
man, I really want to appreciate what you've been doing, man. Like, your work has really helped me in everything I'm doing, everything.
I appreciate that.
I have a question because I have been wavering in my mackish ability and the way I interact with females.
And why have you been doing that? Why have you been wavering in your mackish abilities?
Man, you know, because I heard you could use mackish talk to get anything from females, but I've been having problems getting sex from females. You know, because I'm a freshman and I'm surrounded by attention whores and immature females, and I don't know how to deal with that, you know. So, how do you get sex from females? Because I overthink stuff a lot of times, and I got to admit that. So, how do you think I should go about getting sex from females?
Getting sex from females. Have you read my book, The Art of Mackin?
No, sir.
See, there you go. That's the problem right there. See, a lot of y'all, man, y'all be calling up asking stuff that's laid all the way out in the books. In The Art of Mackin, I have a whole chapter about that on guaranteed ways to get sex, and you can get The Art of Mackin at Amazon.com. Now, with that being said, to get your freak on, in medical terms, you really have to position yourself. It's really all about positioning yourself and being in the right spots. And just like I told the last caller who called in, you got to change up some of the locations you hang out in. And again, just get The Art of Mackin, and that will explain everything, because I don't want to rehash the book here, but get The Art of Mackin, and that'll break the game down for you. Thanks, player. All right. Should I get one more call? Let me get into some game, because we're running out of time. Let me get into some damn game right now. Now, I got an email on Facebook, and for those who don't have my Facebook page is facebook.com/Tariq Elite. You guys should add me to your the Tariq Elite like page. Like it. Because my main Facebook page, I don't think I can add any more friends. So you guys go to the Tariq Elite fan page and add the like button on there, and you can become friends there, and we can still chop up the same amount of good game. But anyway, I got an email from a gentleman. His name is KG. That's the name I'm going to give him. I don't want to put the brother's real name out there. But he sent an email. He said, look, what's up, Tariq? I'm a longtime fan. I wanted to get your advice on this situation, and I'm going to keep it 100% because the shit doesn't make sense to me. Here's the rundown on a girl I've been talking to. She's a white chick, medium length brown hair, 5'7", brown eyes, 130 pounds, athletic. She has a degree and a career. Wonder how old she is. He never specified how old she was. He said she's making bank. She just got out of a 3-year relationship 3 months ago where she left the guy. They used to live together. And she said, fuck it, she's just going to let him keep everything. And she bounced. She's one of these white chicks who likes black guys, but she acts white and she's not into the stereotypical black guy. He goes on to say he has a degree and he has his career going. He's a little cocky, but not over the top with it. So after him and his girlfriend split up, he got convinced to check out online dating. And this is where he met the white girl. which her race doesn't matter, but he met the young lady because the question that he asked, it really transcends race. But he goes on to say that he met this young lady through an online dating service, chopped up game with her. She lives about an hour away from him. They were emailing back and forth. He gives her his number. She calls him up within 15 minutes of him giving her the number, and they chop it up for a couple of days. She says she's feeling him, so they go on a date last Friday night. She drove down to him after she got off work, and honestly, he says the date could not have went any better. There was no awkward silence, not once. They instantly vibed. He said his mouthpiece was tight. There was constant eye contact. His confidence was through the roof. He had her laughing all night. She offered to pay for the dinner, which got mad points from him, and he didn't let her pay. But during the dinner, she said she met two other guys off the little dating website, and she was talking about how they were sensitive and how she hated that, and she was glad that he wasn't like that. He said that these guys were popping up at her job randomly, and one dude told her that he loved her, and she said it creeped her out, so she cut him off. So my brother goes on to say in the email, after dinner, we go outside the restaurant. We sit on the pier overlooking the lake. We continue to chop it up. She says, I really like you. There has to be something wrong with you because you're just a perfect guy. So he comes back with some real smooth, confident remarks, and everything is going well. And he ended the date on a high note by saying, okay, since you have to go to work tomorrow, I'm going to let you go ahead and drive back. He was a perfect gentleman on this date. So she gets home about 2:30 in the morning, and she hits him up thanking him for an evening and all that flirting and back and forth stuff. The date was perfect. So now Sunday rolls around and he barely hears from the girl. They exchange a couple of text messages and that was it. So he said, all right, whatever. She may be testing me to see if I'm going to freak out and get clingy like the other guys. So he didn't take the bait. The email goes on to say, Monday comes around. I don't call her. She doesn't hit me up either. So today, Tuesday, after work, I call her. Only call her once. She sends it to voicemail. And he hasn't heard from her since. My brother goes on to say, well, the girl hit on me first. She drove down here to see me. She asked for a second date. Damn, what the hell happened? I'm not sure if I messed up somewhere, or is she testing me to see if I'm clingy? Should I charge it to the game? Should I hit her up in a couple of days to see what's good? She seems like a cool-ass chick and a quality potential, so I don't know if I should just throw up the deuces or mack her a bit. What would you do? I appreciate it, Tariq. All right. So that was the email. So basically, this guy went on a date with a girl. The date was perfect. The girl had her best foot forward. She was funny. She was making it seem like she wanted to be in a relationship with this guy. She was just putting it on thick. The guy was falling for her. And then the next day, after that, don't really hear from the girl. He's leaving messages. And a lot of guys go through this. A lot of my players out there, you go through situations where everything is cool in the gang on a first date. Sparks are flying, and then you don't hear from the person again. The thing is, man, people forget one of the most important elements of relationships. People talk about relationships a lot, but they forget about one of the main ingredients of relationships. Something that's constantly being overlooked. And this is very important. You forget about consistency. Consistency is a major element in relationships, people. Consistency is really one of the top five most important things in relationships. And I'll do a whole show about the most important things of relationships later on down the line. But we forget about consistency. And the thing is, a lot of people who are very inconsistent, they usually make the best impressions when they are around you. Whenever we deal with somebody who's flaky, they make the best impressions. When you're around them, sparks fly. You feel great about being around them. Everything is fun. Everything is hunky-dory. and then you rarely hear from them. The reason why they're so impressionable when you're around them is because they know that they have to compensate for the inconsistencies. It's just like the movie Boomerang. Boomerang, that's one of my favorite movies, as you guys know. That's my all-time favorite movie. Love that movie, Boomerang. Loved it. And in the movie, Eddie Murphy got sprung because of Robin Givens. Robin Givens pulled the whammy-bammy on him and got him sprung. And the thing is, Robin Givens was very sporadic and flaky towards Eddie Murphy's character in the movie. Sometimes he would call her, she wouldn't answer the phone, and she would show up in an overcoat with nothing on under it, with lingerie, so she would overcompensate for being inconsistent. And in his mind, Eddie Murphy's mind, it was turning him on. But the thing is, you can't really be with somebody who's inconsistent. It's not practical. So you have to think practically when you're in relationships with people or trying to get into a relationship with somebody. And women go through this too. You meet guys, they talk a good game, they're cool in the game, they wine you and dine you when you see them, and then this nigga just disappears for the next 3-4 months. You hear from this nigga every blue moon. See, the thing is, man, to a real player, the first date don't even count. First dates don't count because everybody's going to put their best foot forward on the first date. On the first date, everybody's great. Everybody is laughing, joking. Everybody's trying to make a good impression on the first date. And you never know what a person's ulterior motives are. You never know what the person's ulterior agenda is. You might be with a woman who's just trying to get some attention, and she's being cordial and flirty on a first date, and then you never hear from her again. You may be with a female who's just trying to get a free meal out your ass. So she's laughing and joking while she's sucking up them lobsters and shrimps. Or you might meet a woman who's just being polite on the first date, just saying what she wants you to hear so she doesn't want to be rude. But again, to a player, the first date don't mean shit. First date don't even count. What count is the second date and beyond. The follow-up date, that's what counts. Because that's going to show the level of consistency the female is all about. And the thing is, man, a lot of dudes will throw away a consistent relationship on some superficial, inconsistent ass. I know some dudes that will throw away their marriage over some inconsistent ass. You might meet a little side piece who gives you some pussy every 2 or 3 months, and you're willing to risk your marriage over this little inconsistent side piece. The only thing good is that when y'all get together, the sex is cool in the moment, but dealing with a person like that on a consistent level is not going to work. That's why a lot of jump-off situations don't work when you try to make them into relationships. Some people are cool as hell when they're jump-offs. Sometimes when you deal with a girl, and ladies, when you deal with a guy, when y'all are just fucking, it's cool in the game. But every blue moon, people are like, let's start a relationship. I like fucking. Let's build a relationship around this fucking. And then you try to do it and the shit goes all to hell. Because these people don't have the same level of consistency that you need at that moment in your life. So remember, we gotta have consistency in relationships. That's the most important thing. It's just like getting on an airline. Would you want an airline that gives you great, excellent service, but they're known to crash all the time? You don't want an inconsistent airline. You want, just because they wine you and dine you and give you drinks and Cristal and strippers on the plane, but every other week they're crashing. You don't want that, no matter how well they treat you. You want consistency. It's better to be with something that's average and consistent than extravagant and inconsistent. Let me repeat that. It's better to be with something that's average and consistent than extravagant and inconsistent. You don't want to do that. Now, also, with my homie KG, with the email that he sent, another element about the relationship that he's dealing with this young lady that he just met, the real reason why a lot of people, and I said this a million times, why a lot of people are inconsistent or flaky when you meet them in relationships is because they fucking somebody else. When you meet a woman, fellas, and let's keep it 100, and I've said this a million times, you meet a woman the date is cool, everything is just hunky-dory, everything is fly, and then you don't hear from her, she's with the next damn dude. I wish I can get that concept through guys' heads. And like my dude said, he met the woman on the internet dating site, so you think you're the only dude she's meeting, and she has admitted that she met other dudes. She admitted to two, so that means it's about five or six other dudes that she'd have met off this damn dating site. And she's rotating. She's going all around the rotating circle seeing who's cool. Or she just might be playing musical dicks. She just might be one of those chicks who likes kicking it with a bunch of dudes. So my thing is, don't call women like this over and over again. Don't keep text messaging women like this over and over again. That's a waste of damn time. You calling the woman and her cell phone is going to her voicemail. See, when you call women like that, you calling thinking that she's working or something. And this is the sound they hear when the phone is ringing. When the dude is tearing that ass up, this is what they hear. This is what the other sound is like.
Right there, look at her. Right there.
That's you calling while he's fucking.
Come on, keep that ass up and right there. Yes, 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 yes.
He's talking to that ass.
Get that ass up higher than that. Get that ass up higher.
While your dumb ass is calling,
move up some.
With some roses and a teddy bear in your hand. But like I said, let me put my Mac and music back on. Like I said, man, you don't want to be that dude. You calling this chick while she's laying up with another dude. He's tearing that ass up. All right. Anyway, y'all, that's been today's episode of the Mack Lessons Radio Show. Glad to have everybody tuning in. Don't forget, people, the Hidden Colors film will be coming out in April at select theaters around the country. You don't want to miss that. Also, don't forget to check out MackLessons.com to check out the brand new pay-per-view special called Sex Magic, The Secret Rituals of the Illuminati. Don't forget to go to MackLessons.com, MackLessonsRadio.com, and subscribe to all the shows. You can subscribe to the show on iTunes. All right, I'm going to holler at you guys next week. Also, don't forget, we're going to do a Ustream tonight, live Ustream tonight. Hit me up on Facebook. I'll let you know what time we're going to do it. Holla.